Hello everyone, Master Plan here, and I'm doing a little bit more contrast. I'm making this video to give myself a little bit of a break from Evil Twin. I'm at a section right now that's very difficult because it requires a lot of paper airplane shooting, which, as I've mentioned, is a very touchy weapon that's very annoying to use, especially because you have to shoot it over long distances, which it gets harder to control as you do. Anyway, I might be able to actually wrap up the remainder of Act 2 in this video. It depends on how long the cutscenes are. It may actually be a three-parter like Act 1. I'm sorry, by the way, if I sound like a mouth-breathing neckbeard. This microphone's just really sensitive, and it seems to pick up every time I exhale when I'm done speaking a sentence.
Hey, has anyone seen the princess puppet? We can't really start the story without her.
That sounds like Daddy.
She was right here.
I like how jaded the daughter is. She's like, that sounds like my fucking idiot dad. One little piece of news before I do this. After Contrast is done, which will happen
somewhere pretty
soon, I'm going to start American McGee's Grimm, just so it's a fun little thing that I can kind of pick up and put down, because it's not like a... It's episodic, you know what I mean? And you know my boner for American McGee.
Where did I put her?
Calm the fuck down. I'm coming, okay? Anyway, they're going to do a lot of narration for this thing, so I'm going to try to remain quiet.
Ah, there she is. Once upon a time, there was a princess who lived in a castle with her father, the king. The king loved her very much because daddies loved their daughters. Unfortunately, the kingdom also had an ogre who was eating travelers, because ogres do that. So the king did what kings do and promised that anyone who slew the ogre would get to marry his only daughter, the princess, and become king when he died. The king's lands were very far away, and the ogre was very large. So only one knight showed up. His name was Fred, and he fell immediately in love with the princess. Fred was a brave knight, and he marched off the next morning, singing a brave song as loudly as he could. After several days had passed, the princess got to wondering what had happened to her future husband. So she set off into the forest to look for him. The princess tracked Fred's footprints through a strange wilderness full of scary sounds and hidden dangers. Chasms filled with razor-sharp bamboo. Fortunately, she was a very brave princess who loved adventures, just like you. She used her wits to get past unexpected obstacles. She came to a wide river filled with snapping crocodiles. She couldn't even
shit.
Unfortunately, she fell in the water and drowned.
That's the only time I've ever fucked that up.
She came to a wide river filled with snapping crocodiles. She couldn't even swim. So what do you think she did?
She ran on top of their heads.
That's right. It was a magical forest where the plants seemed to know each other. She had to use magic mushrooms to get high, or up.
I like the pause. She had to use magic mushrooms to get her high, or up. Anyway, what you're supposed to do here is actually hit the middle one first, and then hit this one so that... Oh, wait, no, I'm sorry, I got it backwards. You hit the one that's closest to me right now first, so that when it goes up like that, you can still jump on the one that's on the other side. So I do one... 2, 3, jump. Okay, so when this one goes up, if I can jump on it before it does it, and I can just woo.
She learned to use some bendy tree branches to fling herself across a patch of deadly sharp bamboo. As the sun was setting, she came to the giant ogre's campsite. And there, the princess discovered that the ogre had captured Fred and hung him from a tree as a snack. The ogre did not appreciate visitors at all. Even Fred seemed a little embarrassed to see her.
I gotta be honest with you, this took me forever to figure out.
And she was nimble, and the ogre was clumsy and easy to taunt.
What's a taunt?
That's shit.
When you make fun of someone. You should never make fun of people, but with ogres, sometimes you have to.
The reason that it happened like that is because the first time I ran through this, I actually glitched it to where I stood on his club. And when he pulls it up like that, it gave me a boost when I jumped. And so I actually jumped clean over the tree and it just let me keep going. So I was trying to record this earlier for you guys and I was like, why the fuck isn't it working? Because I thought that's how it was supposed to go. Until I realized you jump over this dumb fuck right here. Then let him bash the damn tree. And you jump back over just in time so you don't die. Like that. I think I might have killed Fred too, but whatever.
And so the princess tricked the ogre and rescued Fred. Fred didn't feel too good about it. He really loved the princess. Fortunately, the king told him about a giant spider that he could slay in order to win the princess's hand. So Fred marched off to the lair of the giant spider, singing a brave song, a little less loudly than before. After several days had passed, the princess got to wondering what had happened to her future husband. So she went off looking for him again.
Which one of us tonight again?
Fred's footprints led her into a dark and creepy cavern, full of strange dripping sounds, kind of like the basement at school. Her footsteps echoed and echoed until it sounded like someone was following her. Soon she came to a vast pit filled with vicious, deadly spikes. It was much too big to jump over, but far off, she could hear moaning. She thought it might be Fred. So what do you think she did?
I know.
What?
She used an umbrella.
What?
Like that nanny in that movie.
This is the Middle Ages, honey. Where would she get an umbrella?
I don't know, but that's what she used.
I don't think I have an umbrella.
Well, you better find one, because she used an umbrella.
Where am I supposed to get an umbrella?
How convenient.
There we go. So the princess bravely threw herself into the air, slowing her fall using an umbrella, just like that nanny in the movie. She floated down into the cave, deeper and deeper into the cavern she floated. She thought she could hear Fred moaning, but maybe it was only the wind.
Maybe Fred's getting fucked up by the goddamn spider I just saw. Fucking up Fred.
Finally, she landed softly, right in a spider's web. Fortunately, it was a very old web, and she was able to break free. Unfortunately, the web was the only thing holding up a giant boulder.
Oh.
The princess needed to find somewhere to hide.
Yeah, I should have let him finish, because I forgot about that. Come on, boulder. We got stuff to do. Those of you playing at home, all you gotta do is tap space twice to break the spider web. What's under here?
Suddenly,
a giant spider
jumped out of the shadows and attacked her.
Great.
She ran and climbed and jumped and climbed, but the giant spider was very good at climbing,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, apparently so.
It had 8 legs, and the princess only had 2.
Oh, damn it. Oh, that's generous of them.
Fortunately, the princess remembered how the webs were holding up boulders.
Are you fucking kidding me? Poor Splinter. Poor me. Here you go, risking my dumbass husband.
Finally, she found Fred. He was all wrapped up like a present for the giant spider's girlfriend. He was dreadfully embarrassed about having to be rescued again.
Because he's an appalling failure.
He really loved the princess. The princess decided he was cute. Fortunately, the king told him about a dragon that he could slay in order to win the princess's hand and stop being so embarrassed. So Fred marched off to the mountaintop of the dragon, singing a brave song, very quietly. After a few days, the princess got to wondering
why her dad kept trying to give her away.
That too. But she was worried about Fred, so she went off to find him.
I forgot about that. That was funny.
The dragon's mountain was cold, and the wind howled at her to turn back. There were rock slides and fiery chasms.
Oh, yeah, there are, aren't
but
there?
But she was very brave and nimble, just like you. She wasn't going to be put off by a few deadly dangers.
Oh, there you are. Okay. Whee! If anybody thinks this looks cool, get the game Limbo. It's exactly like this with the spider and the rocks and everything. I think they kind of ripped off
up
that, actually.
Up and up she climbed. When she got cold, she thought about the hot, buttered muffin she would make once she got Fred home. Do you still like muffins?
I love muffins.
The princess hoped Fred liked muffins.
Something, yeah, I knew something was fucked up here. That would be it. Just run by? Okay. That works for me. That part is also in Limbo.
When the princess got to the lair of the dragon, she was not very surprised to see Fred hanging from the roof of the dragon's cave. So she taunted the dragon until it roared its fiery breath at her.
What's up, nerd? Come at me, bro. One more time. Whoa.
Finally, burning away the ropes that were tying up Fred. And so the princess and Fred lived happily ever after. Fred never had to go on another adventure again, and they had hot buttered muffins every morning. There is another version of the story where the princess flew off on the dragon's back to have a life full of adventures, but that's for another day.
I have a name. Apparently my name is Dawn. Didn't even know that. I'm not sure how we're doing on time, so hopefully if I'm quick with this next section, it won't be too bad and I can cut this in and just do part one and part two. Where is the other part? It requires a lot of shadow platforming, which as you all know, I'm not very good at. Especially Will. And Jules, who are the only people that watch my contrast videos, evidently. But I thank them for it. Where's that stupid balloon? There it is.